Okay, first we're gonna start off with hanging leg ups. We do that because those are by far the hardest. I'm gonna brace her rear end a little bit at her hips to make sure that she doesn't swing. If you're doing these by yourselves, you try not to swing, that's how you know you're doing them right. We're gonna do 4 sets of 10, then move on into hanging knee ups. See how she bent her legs the last 2 or 3. That allowed her to get up past my knee. I'm gonna have her do the next 3 sets with that slight bend in her legs, because I like that extra foot that she was able to get above 90 degrees. Now we're gonna run about a 30-second rest in between the 4 sets. It's gonna be a set of 10, 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 until we're all the way done with 30 seconds rest in between. Let's go.
Perfect. 3, 4, 5, 6,
your knee ups,
7, 8, 9.
The tendency is to let your heels fall back. Don't let them, 10. Good girl. She's now done 20 reps of a very difficult exercise. That's why she's only doing 10 and she still gets a long rest. Good girl.
Awesome.
7, let's heel down. 8, good girl. 9, 10. Now, not only is she working her core, but she's also working her upper body just by having to hold herself there. You figure if it takes her about 2 or 3 seconds to do each rep, she has to do 10. She was holding her body weight for 30 seconds. That alone is a workout for some people. We've evolved to this, hanging abs are a little bit hard, but I wanted this to be somewhat of an advanced core.
Set 4.
10. Now you just saw her totally reset. She had to remove her arm. She was slipping. She was going to fall on her head. How do you prevent that? Step off, step right back on, and finish. She had to readjust her hands a little bit. Of course, they're starting to hurt. And she reattaches herself. She did it twice, okay? She reattached herself twice so she could finish a set of 10. That's all right. She's holding up not a lot of weight, but her body weight.